A massive thank you to everyone who's used my software already. I really appreciate it. And if you're new around here, you should come check out the thing that I've been creating. It's called CalVPN. It's a brand new kind of VPN that can protect you from quantum computers, literally. And you can use it for free right now. We have this free alpha out. It's got these things in it called post-quantum algorithms. And this is why we're calling it a post-quantum VPN. It's literally the first one in the world that you guys can use. So you should come get involved. It would help support my channel if you enjoy my videos. It's only one server, it's only on Windows, but when the beta comes out in about 3 weeks time, you know, everything, there'll be everything. There'll be heaps of servers so you can watch anime in Japan on Netflix. We've got you. So yeah, come get involved. It would mean the world to me. It'd help support my YouTube channel once again. And then finally, the other thing that I'm doing is called the Daily Dance. It's this daily email I send out breaking down the latest in science. It's very short, couple minutes, and you can keep up to date with all the latest breakthroughs. It's nice and pretty looking. Put lots of fun things in there as well. Some positive news, some AI art for every piece. And something personal at the start. And I love writing it. I think there's a lot of value in it because you really can keep up to date. And that's completely free as well. Send it out every single day. I love writing it. So if you want that in your inbox every day, come sign up in the description. Anyway, let's get into this video. Today we're checking out another way to destroy the universe. You might have seen the other video, 3 ways to destroy the universe. So you should go check that out. And in it, I actually talked about vacuum decay, but I cut it out of that video. So I'll put that at the end of this one. I cut it out of that video because it was already getting really long and I realized he had another video specifically about it.
What if our universe comes with a self-destruct button to eliminate itself so cleanly and efficiently that every single physical thing would just stop existing and life would be impossible forever?
Is that like one of those suicide vests? I shouldn't say that in these videos. Yeah, well, I guess if we're in a simulation, I guess the universe could be like, you know, inside a suicide vest, just but yes, vacuum decay would be like resetting a computer, I guess, if we were in a simulation. Anyway,
the ultimate ecological catastrophe, vacuum decay.
Ecological, you mean ecological?
To explain how our universe could destroy itself, we need to understand two principles. One, energy levels.
All right, we're going deep.
A core idea in physics is that everything has an energy level. The higher the level, the more energy is in the system, which, for example, has a high level. It can be burned, a process that releases the chemical energy stored in its molecular bonds and turns it into heat. The ash left over is at a lower energy level than the wood before. Stability. Everything in our universe tries to move towards its ground state, in which it's completely stable and has as little energy as possible. For example, a ball on a hill is unstable and has a lot of potential energy. When disturbed, it will roll down into the valley and lose its potential energy in the process. The ball is now in its ground state and stable. It will remain like that. Everything in our universe follows these two principles. If something has a lot of energy, it's unstable and wants to get rid of it to become stable and reach its ground state. This is true for every system, even in the weird world of quantum mechanics. If our current understanding of physics is correct, then the universe gets its properties from quantum fields. We explain them in detail in another video. For this video, imagine...
Well, this is the limit of like experimentally verified, you know, understanding of physics. Obviously, it goes deeper, you know, you've got other things which there's no evidence for, but which we kind of like, you know, things like loop quantum gravity, things like string theory, but anyway.
As the rules of the universe, they tell particles how to behave and interact. Like everything in the universe, they want to be in the lowest energy level possible, vacuum state. This has nothing to do with vacuum in space. It's just called this way because scientists are bad at naming things.
Let's go back because I missed it.
The lowest energy level possible, which is called a vacuum state. This has nothing to do with how to behave and interact. Like everything in the universe, they want to be in the lowest energy level possible, which is called a vacuum state. This has nothing to do with vacuum in space. It's just called this way because scientists are bad at naming things. We think all the fields reached their vacuum state, except maybe one. It's possible that the Higgs field is not stable, but metastable, which is a fancy way of saying that it pretends to be stable, but really is not. It would be a false vacuum. The Higgs field is responsible for giving particles their mass, which rules how almost everything in the universe interacts. What would happen if the Higgs field is in a false vacuum? Think of our ball in the valley. The ball is the Higgs field. The valley might not be the lowest energy state for the Higgs field. There might be an even deeper valley that it wants to get to. This would mean that the Higgs field has a lot of potential energy waiting to be released. The Higgs field could be like a piece of wood, but drenched in gasoline, waiting to set the universe on fire. A random spark, like quantum tunneling, could release the potential energy of the Higgs field. This could happen at any time.
That quantum tunneling image was not good because, you know, like what the quantum tunneling analogy would be that it literally just disappears and appears on the other side.
And without warning.
You can't talk about what happens when, you know, things quantum tunnel through. In quantum mechanics, that's like hush hush. You're not allowed to even think about that.
If at any point in space this so-called vacuum decay starts, there is no turning back. As the Higgs field crashes into the lower energy state, it releases a massive amount of potential energy. This energy pushes the space around it over the barrier, which releases more potential energy. A sphere of the new stable Higgs field, or true vacuum, grows at the speed of light in all directions. Imagine it like setting a sea of gasoline, the size of the universe, on fire. The sphere is surrounded by a shell of energy that devours everything it comes into contact with. Whatever it touches is eliminated from existence. The bubble will continue to grow forever, deleting the universe on its way. There is no way to be warned since it's so fast, but there's nothing we could do anyway. Our destruction would be instant. In a fraction of a second, Earth would be gone.
Some people actually think that if vacuum decay, you know, takes place, what might be left is like a superheated part of like an extremely dense sphere. And some astrophysicists even believe that the universe itself, just before the Big Bang, might have looked like this, right? Because, you know, the Higgs field is thought to have emerged shortly after the Big Bang, right? And so it might actually be the driving force which, you know, causes the universe to start over again, essentially.
But it actually gets worse. If the energy level of the Higgs field changes, it changes all of physics. In the true vacuum of the sphere, the standard model will be overthrown, superseded by different physics that we don't know. How fundamental particles behave, how atoms hold together, how chemicals react. Vacuum decay won't just destroy life, it will destroy chemistry itself, making life as we know it impossible. We simply have no idea what it would be like inside. It might be a shadow of what it is now. Or not. We don't know. If vacuum decay happens, the outlook is indeed grim. If you feel slightly worried now, don't be. At this point, false vacuum is speculation based on our current understanding of particle physics, which might be wrong. It's kind of like using a ruler to measure a continent. Sure, you can do it, but you might be off by quite a bit at the end. Right now, no one can say if vacuum decay is a thing that's real or just a scary idea. But even if one or multiple spheres of death have already started expanding, the universe is so big that they might not reach us for billions of years. If they're far enough away, they might not ever be able to reach us because of the expansion of the universe. The speed of light is not that fast on the scale of the universe. So while vacuum decay is fascinatingly scary, right now there are other things we should be more afraid of. In contrast to vacuum decay, we have the power to prepare for most of them.
So that was a pretty good explanation. Let's talk a little bit about it. I'm just going to use footage from a previous video, from the previous like three ways to destroy the universe. I talked about vacuum decay in one of them, and I realized there was another video, and the video was already quite long. So I was like, look, I'll save that for today.
There's also another idea, which is, you know, perhaps dark energy could decay, you know, and trigger the onset of like a really different universe. And, you know, usually goes by the name vacuum decay, right? And for some reason, we have this universe with dark energy in it, where the energy is inherent to space isn't zero, right? It has a positive non-zero value. And you could imagine this is because we're not at the bottom of a hill, but because we're in what you call a false minimum, a valley, right? But not the lowest of all possible points. And so if the universe weren't quantum in nature, we'd simply remain in the valley. Right, but you know, in a quantum universe, it remains possible that you could quantum tunnel into the true minimum the lower energy state, right? And if that occurred, well, a number of things could go, you know, pretty bonkers. For instance, the laws of physics and the values of the fundamental constants could change. The energy, you know, previously inherently to space could drop, and that would cause new quanta-like particles and antiparticles to get ripped out of the vacuum. You know, that could trigger a new Big Bang, you know, one a lot lower in energy, colder and less dense than the original. Maybe it would take trillions of years for even a single atomic transition to occur in this new universe. But, you know, as we've all learned from Einstein, it's that time, like space, is relative to the observer.